it was a low point in my life when I had to close my shop. Very simple. Let go and let God. Leave it all up to Him.
The whole thing? Oh my God, what is happening today? Hi dreamers, this is Jerilee Salvador and this is The Pillow Talk, where dreams get unplugged. So our guest for tonight ay isa po siyang veteranong fashion designer, isa po siyang teacher, isa siyang beauty contest winner. And ito po, kasama natin, let's all give a warm welcome to Ms. Jonty Martinez.
Good evening, viewers. Good evening, Ms. Jerilee. It's
Hello
nice
po.
To be here.
Yes, thank you for joining us here sa Pillow Talk. So, ang pag-uusapan po natin is kung paano niyo po dinedefine ang beauty in all aspects. So, mm-hmm. life, mm-hmm. you know, appearances, and of course, through your designs as well. So, yes. yun po ang magiging theme for today's talk.
Okay.
So, but then I would like to start with, kasi mahilig din po kayong mag sumali sa game shows po, di ba?
Oh, yes.
Yes. Uh-huh. And actually, one game show that we've joined together is 1 versus 100.
Oh, yes. yes.
So, yung Kaiser.
Edu Manzano.
Yes, Edu
yes.
Manzano.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah.
So,
so
that
fun.
One.
Yes.
So, you started joining game shows po when?
Okay, I think I started joining game shows in the early 2000s. Mm-hmm. Yes, I joined several. I was in Game Ka Na Ba twice, mm-hmm. Both with Edu Manzano. The first time was yung Atras Abante.
Mm-hmm.
It was really, really competitive because kung if ayaw mo maunahan, papaabantehin mo yung, papaatrasin mo
yes,
yung
yes.
kalaban mo. Mm-hmm. So, madalas ako napapaatras.
Oh.
So, so that was very memorable too. And then another one, I joined with a group of friends mm-hmm. na alam mo yung binabasa ka para mataranta ka,
mm-hmm.
yung taranta
okay.
round. So,
parang,
you'll be asked questions, tapos water mm-hmm. will be sprayed in your face para mm-hmm. hindi mo makuha yung ano. It was really very fun. And then, I was asked to join again for a third time for charity naman.
Ah, okay.
By Mr. Edu Manzano. And then, after that, I also joined, 1 versus 100.
Mm-hmm.
And then, another game show I joined was Panahon Ko To with Luis Manzano.
Like yes. madali sila
yes.
the duo.
Actually,
the
that
fan.
One, I was asked to join.
Mm-hmm.
I was called up by the network and to do parang a pilot
mm-hmm.
For that. So I also joined that. And then I also auditioned for the Chris Aquino show, the one with the suitcases.
Deal or No Deal.
Yes, Deal or No Deal. So I got through that. Because we were around 120, 130 applicants for
mm-hmm.
that time. So when I auditioned, they had a quiz.
Mm-hmm.
So after that quiz, they cut it down to 30.
May pa-exam.
Yes, may pa-exam. Yes, oo. So after that 30, you had to, they did the screen test. So
mm-hmm.
you had to do a lively introduction and talk about yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And then they cut it down to 8.
Mm-hmm.
So we had to come back. The next day, the top 8. So I was mm-hmm. top. I was part of the top 8, and then you had to come with friends and do a mock test of the actual
live,
game,
yeah.
not with Miss Chris, of
uh-huh.
course, but with stand-in.
Mm-hmm.
So we did a mock test, and I came with a group of friends. Some of my beauty queen alagas were there.
Mm-hmm.
So I was told, dalawa na lang kaming pagpipilian.
Mm-hmm.
So, the test went well. Pero, for that particular week, dalawa lang kaming pagpipilian. Pareho pa kaming gay.
Mm, okay.
So, unfortunately, I was edged out because this other gay had a more massa appeal because she came...
story.
Yes, more of the sub-story na mm-hmm. talaga mas makaka... Ano, I think, nagtitinda yata siya ng... meron siyang kariton na nagtitinda
okay.
siya ng... I'm not sure kung gulay or kakanin.
Mm-hmm.
So, sabi nila parang mas ma-appeal yun for their viewers. So,
mm-hmm.
it's okay. I still had fun doing
with
it.
With
the experience. I did it mostly for the experience. And the last was not really a game. I also joined Family Feud. Yes, with a group of designers, from Marene, and then Ronaldo Arnaldo.
Underwear!
We were pitted against mga Mr. International winners.
VH versus world-renowned fashion designers.
Again, I'm doing this for fun. The prize money is actually icing on the cake.
Yes, bonus na lang
bonus
if
na
ever
lang.
You do. But more of like what you... learn and also experience
yes,
in
yes.
it.
Yes, so. And of course, there's the added thrill of being on TV.
Yun po ba is, was that a childhood dream of yours, of being seen on TV?
Not really. It wasn't really a childhood dream. And truth be told, my childhood dream was really to be a doctor. Yes.
Okay.
Why? Because it was inculcated in my mind na malaki ang kita ng doktor.
Financial we needed.
Yes, yes. And at a young age, I was exposed to a lot of my uncles were doctors. So nakikita ko sila. They're very successful. Mm-hmm. Some of my uncles or some of the family friends of my mom and dad were doctors. So nakikita ko, it's they led very, very accomplished lives.
Mm-hmm.
So that was my, yun ang una kong na parang naging seed na sa akin na sige nga, magdo-doktor na lang ako.
Mm-hmm.
When I grew up. So,
and that's what you took up, Puba?
Yes, mm-hmm. I took pre-med, BS Psychology at the Ateneo with the intention of becoming a doctor, going into med school after that.
Mm-hmm.
But unfortunately, siguro when I was my second year, I found out that it wasn't really for me because, you had to dissect animals, frogs, and cats, and it was ew. So sabi ko, paano ba? Sabi ko, mga patay na hayop na nga lang, nandidiri na. What more if I'm going to do this with actual people?
Mm-hmm.
So sabi ko, parang this isn't for me.
Yeah,
so
from that childhood dream, mm-hmm. hindi yun yung nangyari
yes.
in your life.
Yeah, so,
but then, before we go to that mm-hmm. part po na mm-hmm. With what happened after your school life,
mm-hmm.
I want to go back to your childhood ulit po mm-hmm. muna with
okay.
your family life naman po.
Okay. I was very blessed naman to grow up in a very loving family.
Mm.
My dad was, my late dad was a military man. He is a colonel. And my mom was a corporate officer. So,
wow, both parents
yes,
are.
Both parents are very accomplished then.
Mm-hmm.
But early on, because I was gay, so parang mm-hmm. there was resistance from the family. Because number one, because my dad was in the military, so mm-hmm. how would it look if you had a gay son?
Mm-hmm.
Diba? And then number two, my mom comes from an ultra conservative Catholic family.
Ooh, double whammy?
Yes, with a priest for an uncle.
Oh my gosh.
Yes,
okay.
so parang, and you should remember it was the 70s where parang hindi pa masyadong accepted ang homosexuality noon. So parang there were certain challenges I had to to experience mm-hmm. before being finally accepted. There was one in my high school year, the saddest part of my life was really when mm-hmm. I had to run away from home and stay with a gay friend for Christmas. Would you believe I didn't spend Christmas with my family? So because I it was a rebellious stage.
Mm-hmm.
So I was rebelling because I felt I wasn't accepted.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't really I really didn't fit in even in school. I was an achiever during mm-hmm. my elementary years, but somehow during my high school years it slid.
Mm-hmm.
So I wasn't really very in a happy place.
Mm-hmm.
So that happened. And then thankfully doon when we had a heart-to-heart talk with my dad and my mom, so sige, this is really what you are, if this is really what you want to be, or if this is really what we of course you're our son,
mm-hmm.
you're our child, and you're the firstborn, we will accept you,
mm-hmm.
but with certain conditions. You have to finish school.
Okay.
You have to take your study seriously.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be a good brother to your, because I am the I know. So of course there are certain, give and takes for
mm-hmm.
you to, we accept you as our son wholeheartedly, but with your chosen identity, you know, your chosen, you know, sexuality, you have to also give us a certain leeway, because of course, given their background, you have to, syempre, also, we're going to go to this stage together.
Well, it's nice to hear na just like yung thing na sinabi nila is just be a good human being.
Yes.
And then we'll accept you.
Yes. Well, of course, sabi nila, huwag ka magbibigay ng kahihiyan sa pamilya. You know, you have to act a certain way. Especially my dad, who worked in the military. I mean, of course, when we were kids, kailangan gupit lalaki, kailangan ano talaga, I was crying every time we visited the barber. So yun, and then I remember this dinner we had with his general boss. So we were at dinner, so he invited our family, so, and this general also had a gay son. Pero this gay son was naman very discreet, hindi rin ano, whereas I'm very effeminate, diba? So there was this conversation that I think my father didn't think I was listening. So sabi niya, sabi nung boss nung dad niya, nung sa dad ko, meron ka rin palang anak na ganyan. Sabi niya, oo nga, sumasali pa nga sa mga beauty pageant yan. Gawin yung dad ko. So sabi ko, di ka alam, kunyari ako nakikinig. Eh, ba't di mo pinipigilan? Sabi nung general. Sabi nung dad ko nonchalantly, eh, paano pipigilan? Nananalo.
Oh, there you go.
Nananalo. So, paano? Anong pipigil mo? Pwede mo sana sabihin, pigilan mo na yan dahil natatalo ka na. Hindi. Yeah, I was wedding pageant. So, sabi niya, so, okay na. But as long as he doesn't, you know, make pabaya his studies, so that's what's okay. That's what's, and again, one of the conditions they set for me if I wanted to, you know, to go down this path.
And so, that was the experience for you. It was good na na-accept ka after nakapag heart-to-heart talk
yes,
na kayo. And
yes,
because also you have a sibling
yes,
who's also gay.
Yeah, so it was easier for him.
Yeah. You had to go through the rough patches.
Yes,
pero at least, ayun nga, na pagdaanan niyo yun together then.
No, it was harder for me. So it was easier for him na, because napagdaanan ko na lahat ng mga rebellion. And siguro nakikita na nila na okay na, napagdaanan na natin sa panganay. Sabi ko sa bunso, okay na yun.
Tanggap basta, na rin.
Oo, basta mababait silang bata, hindi nagbibigay ng, you know, sakit ng ulo, you know.
So at least it was that with the family. And then after, throughout, naging supportive na with
everything. Oh, yes, yes. After that, I was also, when I say honorably discharged, is very, very, decorative way of saying na kick out from school because of that when I ran away from school.
Oh,
but it was such a blessing
in
disguise because I transferred to a better school where I found my people. You know, my friend. Yes, mas accepted. And it was so uplifting for me to be in that school. San Beda. I love you, San Beda. So yun na nga. So I graduated from high school there with, unfortunately, I wasn't eligible for honors because nag-transfer ako in my third year. But I flourished then. I flourished. I would like to think na I was always in the honor section. And then, as I said, I found my tribe. Up to now, they're still my closest friends, which I, unfortunately, for some reason or another, I never experienced in my old school, even if I spent more years there. With San Beda, with these people, I don't know why. It's just maybe serendipity or fate, as you will call it, na talagang we were all kindred souls as we just celebrated our 40th high school reunion recently, and we went on vacation together, and then we went to parties together. They went home for most of them are based abroad, so we had such a splendid time these last few months.
That's good to find your tribe na.
Yes,
and then so after graduating naman, so diba, the med, and then after graduation, how did you end up finding a job. So hindi niyo po pinush yung
The condition again from my parents was give them the diploma, the college mm-hmm. diploma, which was really a must. Mm-hmm. So I finished my BS psychology, mm-hmm. but I didn't pursue med school na.
Oh, okay.
So even if it wasn't my childhood dream, it was always a passion for me. Fashion was always a passion for me because mm-hmm. If you will look at all my notebooks, I always had doodles mm-hmm. at the back of mostly my female relatives, my mom, my grandmother, my aunts, include sila yung mga earliest models ko eh.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I got to, you know, become more exposed with fashion, with mm-hmm. pageants, so I would draw. But I didn't really think of it as a career until after I graduated.
Okay.
So I applied for the Fashion Institute of Technology in New York, and I was accepted.
Oh, wow.
Yes, but again, fate has this, you know, wrenches. Mm-hmm. They throw wrenches at your mm-hmm. you. Parang ano? Even if I got accepted there, hindi ako nabigyan ng visa. The student visa. I was denied the student visa by the U.S. Embassy. So, I cried my eyes out because I thought, ay, naku. So, parang...
That would have been a great
opportunity. But then again, of course, because this is God's will, I always think that this is God's will, everything that happens. So, I stayed here and I applied for first an RTW firm.
Mm-hmm.
So I stayed there for a year, and then I applied at a boutique. Mm-hmm. Shout out to my mentor Leonard Ko, mm-hmm. where I stayed for almost a decade.
Mm-hmm.
So he molded me into the designer that I am. I learned the ropes of running a shop from him, deal with clients, mm-hmm. And then how to do business, mm-hmm. you know, because fashion is not just all about glamour. You have to mm-hmm. know the business side of it. So it's a really, really hard work.
Mm-hmm.
So after my stint with him, I put up Galatea in 1999.
Yes, this mm-hmm. is your own now.
Yes, my own, and with my brother.
Yes.
So we were a team then. Yeah, we were in Camuning, and then again, as I said, I also flourished there.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever I learned from my previous job with Leonard, na-apply ko siya.
Mm-hmm.
And then I grew by leaps and bounds here for 21 straight years.
Wow, so creating your own design.
Yes. When I was there, I became a member of the Fashion Designers Association of the Philippines,
mm-hmm.
and I stayed there. I was an officer for a record 16 years.
Wow. Congrats.
And then I experienced fashion shows abroad
mm-hmm.
while I was there. I joined fashion shows in the US, Hawaii, mm-hmm. LA, New York, New Jersey, and then I was also invited to be part of the Canada Philippine Fashion Week.
Mm-hmm.
And then I also held a fashion show just before the pandemic in New Zealand, my own solo fashion show in New
wow.
Zealand naman, at the invitation of my friend Ludwig.
Yes, mm-hmm. ang dami niyo na pong napagdaanan
yes,
with this.
It was very, very fruitful naman.
Mm-hmm.
I was also, during that time, I was also, aside from being designer, I also was a beauty queen
mm-hmm.
mentor.
Mm-hmm.
I discovered a lot of beauty queens then.
Mm-hmm.
Because being a fashion designer, of course, another one of my passions was pageants.
Mm-hmm.
I remember the very first pageant I watched was Miss Universe 1973,
mm-hmm.
which was held here in the Philippines. So I was already very transfixed with that.
Mm-hmm.
So, from then, sasabi ko sige, it segued into me joining pageants
mm-hmm.
when I was young. And then, again, it evolved into me being a pageant handler,
mm-hmm.
mentor, trainer, whatever you want to call it.
Mm-hmm.
That was the time na talagang, during that time I was designer, it was parang another
a
wing.
Bridge.
Yes,
yeah.
another part of me that I cultivated.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And so as a fashion designer mm-hmm. and then beauty queen also, mm-hmm. I'm interested to know kung ano po bang sinasuot niyo when you're asleep. So,
oh, okay.
Ano pong, when you're not working, this is okay. You just in your...
Okay, sige. Of course, when you're sleeping, the primary element you have to think of is comfort.
Yeah.
So when I sleep, it's not this. This is lounge
fashion.
Yeah, no. But when I sleep, it's just a sando and shorts.
Presko.
It's actually, I don't know if I got this from my dad. It's the oldest sandos you have. It's comfort,
yes.
Eh.
Oh,
it's
mga butas-butas pa.
Mga butas-butas pa. Oh, mga kinakagat-kagat ko. So it's the whole oldest sandos I have. And then, you know, yung mga shorts lang, jersey shorts, sa talagang drawstring lang.
Mm-hmm.
So, ganun lang ako matulog.
Yes, mm-hmm. Very far from your designs,
yes.
With the intricate beading.
Yeah, so when I go out, mm-hmm. Like kunyari, when I go to parties or even when I teach, I want to look my best.
Oh, okay. So even while teaching, design, yeah.
Yes, as a designer, mm-hmm. As everything, because it's who you are, how you present yourself is a big
yes.
part of not just your job, but it's of you, who you are.
Mm-hmm.
You are being judged with how you look.
Mm-hmm.
So I make it a point now when I am, like here, I'm on camera. So I have to, I cannot come here wearing my old sando, di ba? So I make it a point really that I am really, really prepared and well-dressed.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And speaking of being well-dressed, mm-hmm. You were very well-dressed po when you joined the Miss Q&A sa Showtime, right?
Yeah. Show.
That's another show that, you know, that's a very memorable, you know, part of my life, 2017. Mm-hmm. So I really wanted to join when they said, oh, sabi ko, this is fun. Mm-hmm. Sabi ko parang, and then I saw a lot of my Contesera friends join. Mm-hmm. Sabi ko, kaya lang, sabi ko, I had to take into account my mom. Parang,
okay.
So what I did was, sige na nga, I'll try to audition lang and see if I can pass.
Mm-hmm.
So during the end of season one, like the last week of mm-hmm. their daily rounds, I secretly auditioned with my friend, my Mama Louie. So, mm-hmm. Pinikapan niya ako. So, I auditioned. So, when I auditioned, so you have to go through the three rounds.
Mm-hmm.
The three rounds that you have to introduce yourself, and then you go through the parang their question and answer. Mm-hmm. You have to go through the buzzer. And then, I would like to think I made an impression because the auditioner said, ba't ngayon ka lang nag-audition?
Parang hinihintay ka na nila.
Ba't ngayon ka lang? Sabi niya, wala. Sabi ko lang, sabi ko parang hindi kompleto ang pagiging kontesera ko
mm-hmm.
if I don't audition for this. Sabi mm-hmm. ko, okay lang yon. So sabi ko, okay. So it was a Monday. I remember it was a Monday. I auditioned mm-hmm. on a Monday. Wednesday, I got the call.
Mm-hmm.
Sabi ko, can you come Thursday mm-hmm. to join na? And that Thursday, it was the recognition day of my niece, my mm-hmm. favorite niece, Pia. So sabi ko, I couldn't na. Sabi ko, no, I don't. I'm sorry. Sabi ko, I can't. I have already, a previous engagement already.
Mm-hmm.
Sabi ko, okay. So sabi ko, sa loob-loob ko, siguro talagang ayaw. No? Sabi ko, at least I know I passed the audition
mm-hmm.
that they wanted to call me back. So parang sa loob-loob ko na lang, okay na yon. Sabi ko, okay na yon. And then, Friday, they called up again.
Mm-hmm.
Can you join on Saturday, the very last day?
Mm, they really wanted you there. Yeah.
Okay, can you join on Saturday? Sabi ko, ay, sige, sabi ko, ito na eh. Sabi ko, mm-hmm. This was the second call eh. Alam mo, Marty pa ako. So sabi ko, sige, I'll join. Okay. And then I went to my mom. Sabi ko, mom, can I join? Sige, na, give me your permission. Sabi niya, di pa ba bastusin ka lang doon? Baka mamaya bastusin ka lang. Sabi niya, nakikita raw niya, napapanood niya. Of course, let's be honest, minsan napaglalaroan ni Vice yung mga candidates, yung mga sabi niya. And she doesn't want that for me, di ba? Sabi niya, hindi naman siguro.
Alam mo, si number
2,
kilala ko yan.
Outstanding.
At saka sikat yan sa mga
bandidati. It depends din naman sa
guest. It depends on the guest. Sabi ko, so, okay, so sige. So I joined mm-hmm. and then if you will watch the video, parang in YouTube,
yes.
I was well accepted naman. And
yes.
Anne, the reason why I also wanted to join, because I haven't seen Anne for the longest time
mm-hmm.
because I dressed up Anne during her debut.
Did you recognize me na Anne?
Jaunty?
Yes!
Sabi ko na nga! Kinaka-recognize mo siya.
Oo, Johnny Martinez. Yes. Alam mo ko bakit siya ang gumawa ng damit ko ng dibu ko noong 18 years.
Oh my God, for real?
And then, when I joined Flores de Mayo, my friend Dick suggested, ba't di mo kunin si Anna magsagala?
Mm-hmm.
Papayag kaya yon? Sabi ko, artista na yun, baka hindi siya pumayag. Sabi niya, tanong mo lang, sabi niya. So, tinanong namin, she agreed naman. And that her boyfriend at that time was Oyo Boy Soto.
Mm-hmm.
So, may bonus. Siyempre, kailangan si Oyo ang
magka-pair sila.
Magka-pair sila, oo. So, from then, there, so nagsagala sila. And then, when it was time na for Anne's debut, she came to me na, would you like to do my debut gown? Sabi niya, of course, sabi ko, of course. And then sige, how much will it cost? Of course, nothing. That's my gift to you. That's my gift to you. Sabi ko, that's my gift to you. Sabi ko, because you were such a gracious sa gala.
Mm-hmm.
So, so yun na nga. And then after, when she transferred to ABS, because I didn't know the stylist in ABS, so nawalan kami ng contact.
Mm-hmm.
So when the chance for me to join Miss Q&A came, sabi ko, it would be a nice reunion with me for
to reminisce.
Anne. Yes, oh. And then yun na nga, when Vice was busy with the other contestant, interviewing the other contestant, nagka-moment kami ni Anne. Kami nagbubulungan lang kami. Sabi ko, kamusta ka na? Sabi ko, ito. Sabi niya, can you believe I'm 30 na? Gawagano siya. I was only 18 when you dressed me up. Yes, sabi ko, yes. Oo. Sabi ko, and then, sabi ko, I saw you at Binibini Pilipinas. I wanted to greet you. Bakit hindi po greet? Sabi niya. she's very sweet.
Yes. Yes.
You know, she's very sweet. One of the sweetest. Very, yes. Very sweet.
So it was nice na naging parang reunion nyo pa yun.
Yes.
It's like a nice combination of the things you love doing,
yes.
Right? So
yes.
Joining game shows.
Yeah.
Joining
pageants.
Fashion design and pageants.
Oh, and then getting to meet Anne and Vice again.
Yes. So with the pageants naman po, how did that go for you? So how did it start? And then, kasi sabi niyo po na you were, yun yung naging bridge niyo din from fashion design to beauty contest. And then, ano po yung naging first niyo na contest?
Oh, well, kasi I had my college friend, of course, my high school friend, Leadership Nori.
Daming shout-outs.
Shout-outs, syempre. They're part of my life.
Yes.
Sabi niya, alam mo, kumontest ka. Sabi niya, mag-join. She was already joining then. Mag-join ka ng pageant. Sabi niya, talaga? Sabi niya, oo, masaya, dali. Sabi ka, papakilala kita doon sa nagme-makeup sa akin, Mama Louie. Sabi niya, sali tayo. O sige. So sabi ko, sige. Paano naman yung mga susuotin ko? Ganyan. Bahala na. Let's do na. You know, the first gown I wore, I bought it in Bambang. Yung palengke. Yung mga, mga used gowns.
Mm-hmm.
Oo. And then, it was actually a dress na I know it's parang lame ng copper.
Mm-hmm.
And then, bumili lang ako ng ng tela na satin
na
ginawang palda para maging gown.
Mm-hmm.
Dinala ko sa sa isang mananahi sa Malabon also. Can you believe, 30 pesos lang.
Wow!
So, yun na. So, after that, and then, nandiyo-join ako ng pageants.
Mm-hmm.
And then, nanalo nga naman because of course, when you win, so
sabi ko, keep going.
And then it boosts your confidence,
yes, diba? Yes.
It's a game, eh.
Yes.
If you lose in a game, ba't ka pa maglalaro, diba? So yun na nga. And then, one time, I joined in Bicol.
Mm-hmm.
So, it was also palapitan naman ng Christmas. Ang sabi ko lang sa parents ko, ay, magbabakasyon na kami ng friends ko.
Mm-hmm.
Eh, parang nag-extend yung pageant na hindi nila alam, walang cellphone noon.
Mm-hmm.
So hindi nila alam kung paano ko kukontakin. Hindi pa ako umuwi. Sabi ko, uwi ako this day, hindi pa ako umuwi.
Mm.
So, hinalungkat nila yung mga yung mga gamit ko. So, na-discover nila that it was joining pageant. So, sabi ko. So, yun na nga. Again, we had the talk, you can only join one pageant a month, and then as long as it doesn't affect your studies, you will be allowed. Plus, of course, the money you will win, you have to share it with your siblings, which I did naman. So, pag may prize naman ako, sinishare ko naman sa mga kapatid ko.
That's good. And you shared with your family then.
Yes.
And then, so, after a while, you end up designing for beauty contests as well.
Yes. So, because it was my passion, I began parang scouting na rin for girls. Of course, as a designer, you're being asked to judge a lot of pageants. So, tinitingnan ko na yung mga girls and then I will approach them. Would you like to join a national pageant? Ginagan ko. Or would you like to... Siyempre, most of them, hindi pa uso-uso yung mga glam team na yan. Mm-hmm. So, paano po yun? Sabi ko, akong bahala sa'yo. Akong bahala na mag-train sa'yo. Akong bahala magdamit sa'yo. I have my friend, Mama Louie, para mag-makeup sa'yo. So, parang ano. So, we started na looking out for girls. So, in 2002, I started dinamitan ko sa Mutya ng Pilipinas, placed first runner-up. And then, the following year, sinali ko naman yung isang na-discover ko sa Mutya ng Malabon. Sabi ko, Jamie Liz. And she won. She was my very first beauty title holder. So, she won Mutya ng Pilipinas that year. And then, after that, ang dami ko nang naipanalong mga girls. If you will also remember, Janina San Miguel. She was Miss Bidibidi Pilipinas World in 2008. She's also my alaga. And then I also have a couple of international winners. So there is April of Jordan, my love, the late April of Jordan, who won in China. There's Justine Gabionza, who was Miss Green International, Green Tourism International. And then Sofia Senoron was Miss Multinational, and Jani Alipoon, Miss Tourism International.
So
I went also to I went for Jani's Jan. I went to Malaysia to watch her. So I was there when she won. So it was really very 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 exciting kasi there were around 50 girls. So talagang, and she did really very very well.
I'm sure sobrang proud po kayo sa lahat ng mga naging alaga niyo.
Yes, yes.
And like from everything you've learned, so from all that you have, from bottom up na you know everything, all the business and all that. So you opened up your own boutique shop.
Yes, yun nga. I specialized in a lot of formal wear. That was the bread and butter of shops naman, yung mga weddings. So there was a time I did like 13 weddings a week.
Oh my gosh, that's a lot.
So it's also really very stressful. So that went on for, like I said, 21 years. And I was also blessed to have a very loyal and very hardworking staff because that's the backbone. You can only do so much designing without a staff. What are you? So I was blessed with that. I was also blessed with a lot of loyal clients. So that kept me running for 21 years. And sadly, it was only the pandemic that, you know, shut me down. So the pandemic happened in 2020. So we had to shut down operations on March. So we didn't know how much. I thought it was going to be a two-week, one-month thing. So when it stretched to around a couple of months, I already asked my landlady, what will happen? Because we haven't been operating for this long, what will happen to our to our business? Sabi niya. Well, I interviewed some of my designer friends, and their landladies naman were very considerate of giving them a discount or even free. You don't pay anything as long as you're closed. I didn't have that same consideration, which I also understand. It's a business thing.
Yes.
My landlady said that, sige, ganito na lang. Huwag ka na muna magbayad habang sarado ka. But when you open again, you can start paying for the months that you were closed on a staggered basis. Okay. Which was, teka, parang nagbayad na rin ako sa ano. Sa isang pwesto na hindi ko ginamit and that didn't really generate business for me, which was, I think, like flushing money down the toilet. So sabi ko, maybe this is a sign for me to close na.
So that's when you decided?
Yes, that's when I decided mm-hmm. to close na. So sabi ko, I had a good run as a fashion mm-hmm. designer.
Long years, 21 yes, also.
21 yeah. on my own, plus mm-hmm. the decade I spent with Leonard and the 1 year I did with RTW. So that's more than 30 years. So sabi mm-hmm. ko, siguro, tsaka, truth be told, I was already beginning to feel burnt out mm-hmm. during the last, you know, the last years of my ano, parang I was feeling this is beginning to feel like work anymore. I'm not enjoying this anymore. Mm-hmm. Parang nawawala na yung mojo ko mm-hmm. with designing. I mean the creative style, the creative part is still very, you know, fulfilling, but when it comes to business, parang nakakapagod na rin, mm-hmm. you know, sabi ko. So siguro parang it's the Lord's way of saying na okay, you've had a good run, so it's time na to, you know, a graceful exit. And this was a graceful exit. Yes. I mean, hindi ako nalaos, mm-hmm. hindi ako nalugi, hindi ako mm-hmm. nagsara dahil hindi na ako tinatao, di ba? Yeah. Parang at a great point in my career, it took a global pandemic for me to mm-hmm. close down. So parang okay, sabi ko, sige Lord, this is what you want.
Yeah, parang close that chapter, yeah, pero open chapter. A new one, which is teaching.
Yes.
Naman
yes.
yung nangyari.
Yes. So from 2020 I was, you know, chill mm-hmm. sa bahay lang. So sabi ko, I embraced retirement, early retirement. For me it was early retirement. Mm-hmm. So, when the opportunity came for me to teach, sabi ko, teka muna, because I was really praying na it's mm-hmm. too early for me to retire. I still have a lot of gifts that mm-hmm. you gave me for me to use and for me to share to other people. So give me that. So during the pandemic, I kept on, you know, applying for, you know, call centers.
Wow,
just to keep me busy. Because
mm-hmm. Do something,
yeah. Diba? Or for online teaching, mm-hmm. English tutoring,
yes,
di ba?
Yeah.
Or for some reason, hindi ako natatanggap. I would pass, you know, the initial exams, mm-hmm. the interviews, but for online teaching, you know, you really had to have your background all white.
Yes, and I do that
yes,
now, so I
yes,
know.
Also, hindi ganun yung setup ko sa bahay. Mm-hmm. Like the setup of my PC was nasa living room, mm-hmm. so daan-daan ang mga tao,
yes.
so hindi pwede. Mm-hmm. So, and then, for a BPO naman, when I was interviewed, the interviewer told me, you know, you sounded a little more, you know, for want of a better word, arrogant.
Oh.
Yes, maybe because, sabi ng sister ko, maybe it's because you're more mature.
Mm-hmm.
And they're looking for younger people na who, mm-hmm. you know, mas malumanay magsalita,
mm-hmm.
because maybe you're Atenista ka, may iba ang bagsak ng salita mo.
Arrogant or maybe confident?
Maybe, yes.
Yeah, but that's a better word, I would say.
Yes, maybe a little, maybe a little more, a little too assertive.
Maybe,
assertive. Mm-hmm. So, hindi ako natanggap. So, mm-hmm. sabi ko, maybe it's not for me, mm-hmm. and I wouldn't have enjoyed it anyway. Mm-hmm. It would be work again, and I don't like working. I like doing things mm-hmm. that, you know,
passion talaga.
Well, yes, the passion.
Mm-hmm. So you ended up teaching.
Teaching, yes. When this opportunity came, oh my God, it was such a godsend.
Mm-hmm.
Sabi ko, talaga? Sabi ko, because you can teach. Sabi, mm-hmm. you have a master's degree, you can teach in college.
Mm-hmm.
Sabi ko, what will I teach? Fashion design. Oh my God,
makes
yes.
a lot of sense.
Yes.
Yeah.
that still puts me in the industry I love,
yeah.
but in a different role.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm now mentoring future fashion designers, mm-hmm. which I love. And I love teaching. I love being in front of a crowd, you mm-hmm. know, or being the contestera part of me still there.
Yes.
You know? So it was such a godsend. And I thank God every day for the blessing that is teaching.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And yeah. now parang you get to impart your knowledge from all the years of experience.
Yes, yes. Uh-oh. And to young people, and being around young people is such an invigorating experience.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And speaking of helping other people, mm-hmm. you also do charity work.
Yes.
Uh-oh. Can you tell me about
okay,
that?
So when I was doing my thesis for my master's degree, mm-hmm. It was, I had to work in a community, in indigent community with children with special needs. That was mm-hmm. my thesis. How economically challenged families raise children with autism. Mm-hmm. I have a niece, a beloved niece who has autism, and mm-hmm. she's my world. Mm-hmm. So that's why I took up my master's with special education.
Oh, okay. All connected then.
Yes, yeah. Also connected then siya. So when I did my thesis, so doon na nga. So I turned 50 that year.
Mm-hmm.
So sabi ko, sige, as a way to celebrate, let me do an outreach, a gift mm-hmm. giving for this community who welcomed me into their arms, diba? Because, let's have a birthday party there where imbis na ano, I will be giving out gifts. And mm-hmm. I brought clowns and mm-hmm. Entertainment, and then I brought refreshments, merienda, mm-hmm. Then gift giving. I asked for their list of sino mga children na bibigyan and their wish list. Mm-hmm. So I sent out feelers to my friends. Oh, baka you might want to be part of this project I have.
Mm-hmm.
So they responded naman. Oh, sige, I'll give gifts, I'll give ganyan. So, mm-hmm. yun. So that was the first year, 2016. So, nilapitan ako nung community, sabi niya, Teacher Antonio, that's what they call me. We don't have barangay support anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Would you mind doing this as for Christmas, mm-hmm. for the next Christmas? Sabi ko, sure, sige. Sige. Ganun din, the same thing. I would reach out to friends and then we would pool our efforts mm-hmm. for the gifts and then, I've been doing this for the past, 7 years, 8 years now.
Beauty queen talaga, living that beauty queen life.
Yes, but, it's also very...
From the heart talaga.
Yes, when you give... I would like to think that I'm very blessed. Mm-hmm. And when you're very blessed, you share.
Yes.
You share. Talaga, ang dami-daming binigay sa'yo ni Lord. You impart, you give out, mm-hmm. diba? Especially these children, these people with special needs, diba? Mm-hmm. So it's very, very, really, very uplifting.
Yes. Sometimes it's even better. It feels better pag nagbibigay po tayo kaysa yung tayo yung nakatanggap ng something.
Yeah, because that's what I told my friends. Don't give me gifts anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Hindi naman ako mahilig sa mga trinkets. Hindi naman ako mahilig sa ano. Mm-hmm. Give na lang to this to this outreach I have every mm-hmm. year. Diba? So yun na lang yun ang gift niyo sa akin.
Bigyan share the blessings to others.
Yes, oo.
That's so nice.
Yes, oo.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so for you po, well, you're a very giving person. Mm-hmm. Pero kayo po ba, who motivates you?
Oh, again.
Para kanino po kayo na nananaginip at patuloy na nangangarap?
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. That would be my family, of course. Mm-hmm. Oo. And most especially my niece, mm-hmm. yung Pia. She's my greatest joy. She gives me my makita ko lang siya. Kahit anong ganong pagod or inis mm-hmm. ko sa buhay or stress ko sa buhay, makita ko lang siya. Nawawala lahat. I didn't know that you could love a person this much.
Parang anak nyo na rin po.
Yeah, parang anak ko na siya. Sinasabi ko nga sa sister ko, hindi mo anak yan. Anak mo lang yan dahil pinanganak mo siya, pero ako, akin yan. I say that to her. Parang an afterthought ko na lang na parang iniisip ko na binigay siya ng Diyos para sa akin.
Mm-hmm.
For me. Lagi ko sinasabi sa kanya yun, you were given to me through my sister.
Mm-hmm.
Diba? But you're really mine.
Aww, it's nice that you have that kind of relationship.
Yes.
Uh-oh. And I wanted to ask you lang din po na if you were to give advice
mm-hmm.
to the people who are experiencing like things that are similar na you've gone through, mm-hmm. what would you like to tell them? Both sa like fashion design and mm-hmm. like wanting to help other people mm-hmm. and like teaching or ano pong gusto niyong sabihin sa kanila?
Very simple. Mm-hmm. Let go and let God.
Mm-hmm.
Oo. Leave it all up to Him. Yun ang during the pandemic, yun ang naging dasal ko. I leave it all up to you because it was a low point in my life when I had to close my shop. Mm-hmm. So financially, I was not wanting. I was not wanting. We were all healthy.
Mm-hmm.
I had my family. I had my friends. So, but there was still something lacking na talagang parang hindi pa rin ako mabuo-buo na. I had to you know, I had to do something pa, mm-hmm. no? So, sa, yun ang naging dasal ko. Mm-hmm. So, I leave it up to you. Everything, everything. From growing up, na the challenges that I faced, you know, with my identity and such.
Mm-hmm.
At the back of my mind, talagang I left it all up to him. Ikaw nang bahala.
Mm-hmm.
You know what's best. Everything is carved out for you the moment you are born. Mm-hmm. I really believe that. Na it's already laid out for you, so you just let him.
Mm-hmm.
He's the driver. Tagasakay ka lang.
Yes.
Oo. So for all the people at any point in your life, just leave it all up to God.
Mm-hmm.
Professionally, you know, with all your personal problems and challenges that you face in your life, with even with health or with mm-hmm. Romantic ties or whatever you're feeling right now, just leave it all up to him, mm-hmm. and he will provide. God always provides.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So there you go. There mm-hmm. you have it. Thank you for that very fruitful message and very fruitful life that you shared with us.
And thank you for your interest.
Yes.
For thank inviting you. Me to this podcast.
Dreamers, for listening. Mm-hmm. And that's it. Good night and sweet dreams.
Good night. Sweet dreams.
Bye.